Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we will be talking about 5 basic tips that anyone who is willing to learn watercolors must know. Also, at the end of this video, I will be sharing a bonus tip that will completely change your watercolor game. So make sure you watch the video till the very end. Like every other painting medium, watercolors also have certain properties that you must know before you begin working with them. So today, I'm going to talk about 5 those important properties of watercolors that you need to know before you start working with watercolors. The very first point in this basics is that choosing the right kind of paper. Since watercolors and all the techniques that are involved with watercolors require multiple overlaying washes, it is advisable that you take a watercolor paper which is 240 GSM or more. Ideally, professionals use 100% cotton 300 GSM watercolor paper to make their watercolor paintings. But those kind of sheets are not quite affordable, so if you are a beginner, I would suggest you to get a 25% cotton 300 GSM paper to practice the skill. You can check out brands like Bristro, Minora, Anupam and Canson to find such sheets, and I can tell you I have used those sheets and they are really good with watercolors. The best part of 300 GSM watercolor paper is that it offers very good water retention, so the sheet does not dry up very quickly and offers you a little time for you to work with the watercolors. For example, if you are painting loose, you need the sheet to be wet for some time so that you can add the loose effect to the sheet. So in that case, 300 GSM watercolor paper works very best. The second most important property or technique that you must master when you work with watercolors is the concept of layers. If you have worked with other mediums like acrylics and gouache, you would have followed an approach in which you first have worked with the darker tones and then you would have moved toward lighter details. But in watercolor, this technique works backward. You first have to work with lighter washes and then move your way up to darker tones. The reason why concept of layers is important is that if you want your painting to look vibrant and colorful after all the colors have dried up, you have to apply multiple layers so that the pigment is retained and the output or the artwork looks really vibrant at the end. So you have to work with multiple layers to get the desired vibrant output. The third most crucial point of watercolors is that always let the first layer of color dry and then proceed with the other details or the second layer. When you are working with watercolors, you have to be patient and let the first layer dry and then proceed with the details or the second layer. Why this is important is that if you do not let the first layer dry and apply different color or apply different shade or details on that color, the color simply spreads all over the wet area and there is no way you can undo that. So if that happens, your painting is destroyed. So you have to make sure that you first let the first layer dry and then proceed with the details or the second layer. The exception of course lies when you are painting loose. In that case, you have to have the sheet wet so that you can splatter color on it or apply color on it to have that loose effect on your painting. But if you are painting landscapes and you are working on artwork which has multiple details, you have to let the first layer dry and then proceed with the details. The fourth point that I want to share with you is that keep the colors handy before you start working with them. Whenever you work with watercolors, I would advise you to mix a little more color than what you need for your painting. This is because if your color finishes off in the mid of your painting session, you would have to create or take out that color again in your palette. And when that happens, if accidentally you take different proportion of water and color, the shade might get altered. And in that case, the difference of shade could appear in your main painting. So make sure you first take out the color in excessive quantity in your palette itself before you sit down to paint. So mix the color that you would need in your painting in advance and in sufficient quantities. The fifth point and the most important point that I want to talk about, and I have talked about it earlier also, is learning the importance of layers in watercolor. The only drawback that others might feel with watercolors is that it requires effort and patience. Effort in the sense means you have to work with multiple layers to get a vibrant output and to have that pigment of color retained in your painting. You have to work with multiple layers. And patience in the sense you have to let the colors dry and then you have to go with another layer or another detail. So that requires a little patience. Building on this particular point, here is the bonus tip that I wanted to share with you. Always let the first layer dry, then work with the second layer. I have talked about this particular point earlier also, and I cannot stress enough on this. Why I'm suggesting this is that if you try to apply the second layer on an already wet sheet, it might create clogs of water over the sheet. What happens is that if you then add color on this clogs of water, it offers that cloggy effect on your sheet, and that is not good. It does not look very good on your final painting. Also, if there are clogs of water on the sheet, the pigment of color dilutes itself because of the excessive water. So make sure that there are no clogs of water on the sheet when you are applying the second layer. Also, if the sheet is excessively wet, it will automatically rip off with your brush strokes, and that would appear in your final art piece. So make sure that your sheet is not excessively wet with the clogs of water. When we are beginning with watercolors, we don't know how much water is sufficient for the sheet and that it would retain the color of water on the sheet. So we apply a lot of water on the sheet. So just make sure you apply a very thin coating of water and you do not let the water to form clogs over the sheet. So these were the 5 points that I wanted to share with all of you. If you enjoyed this video and all the tips that I shared with you, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon to stay connected for more such insights in my upcoming video. With that being said, if you have any more queries, feel free to comment them down and I will surely respond to them. So take care and I will see you in the next video. Bye!